Would you like to learn how to self-publish a children's book? More importantly, would you like to learn how to actually format your children's book for ebook and with a free program? Do I have your attention yet? Well, make sure you stay tuned for more information. Self-published authors get a chance to win a piece of $12,500. Get more details from our sponsors in the North Street Book Prize competition later in this video. Hey, I'm Dale L. Roberts, a best-selling author as well as a self-publishing advocate who wants to show you how to publish books that sell. And today marks the third part in a four-part series on how to self-publish a children's book. And more specifically, we're going to focus on formatting your children's book into an ebook. If you missed the previous steps, it's important that you go back because the very first step we talked about researching the keywords in the niche, and then we talked about writing and producing the content for your children's book. The very first step that we're going to be doing is you're going to search for Kindle Kids Book Creator. And it's available from Amazon. Do not download this software from any other site but Amazon. And it'll probably be on like an Amazon help page of some sort. But you're gonna download that and install it. And it's available for both PC and Mac users. Now to format the ebook, what we're gonna do is we're gonna open up Kindle Kids Book Creator. You're gonna click Create a New Kids Book. Review the instructions. After you're done reviewing that, you're gonna wanna make sure you click Continue. Now enter all of the relevant metadata. This includes the title, the author name, the publisher. Now this is optional, you don't have to have this. The book's language, and where to save the files on your computer. Click Continue once you're all set. Now, select how readers will view your book. Will it be landscape or portrait? Now if it's in portrait, it's just going to be up and down, almost like you see over an Instagram stories or something like that. With landscape, it's the other way, almost like when we see a television. You're gonna have two images or one image for landscape. And you can also choose the first page on the right or on the left. Click Continue once you've decided on your layout. Now comes adding the cover and pages. Now, full disclosure, I prefer adding the cover to the actual children's book before I upload it over to Kindle Kids Book Creator. It just makes things a little easier and a little less difficult. So if for some reason in the last steps, the last video, you didn't have the cover in the very first page, I'd recommend you backtrack and then export it to PDF that way with the front cover. Make sure you save it as a PDF and then title it ebook, because this is for ebook only. You won't need to do that PDF for the print that way. In the event you don't have the cover, no worries, we can go ahead into the very next step. You can always add it now. Choose your cover image. Now start adding pages, and all you're gonna have to do is find your PDF, then click open. Before we get to the very next step, I wanna share with you how you can win up to $5,000 with your self-published children's book. Winningwriters.com presents the 6th annual North Street Book Prize competition that is available for self-published authors just like you in 6 different categories, and one of those categories happens to be children's picture books. They're awarding up to $12,500 for all the winners across various categories. If you'd like to enter for a chance to win the grand prize of $5,000, head on over to winningwriters.com/Dale. A pop-up window is gonna come up and it says, you have successfully imported your pages. Now the very next step you're gonna do is you can either add pop-up text boxes or just regular text boxes. Now, when it comes to pop-up text, it's kind of like an Easter egg. So you can actually put something somewhere and click on it and it'll actually pop up some information. This only works obviously on ebooks, but it's kind of a fun and interesting way to do your stuff. Or if for some reason the print's too small, this is one of the nice ways to get it to where it's more readable for folks. They can click on that little pop-up and see it. So we're gonna go ahead and click Add Pop-Up, adjust the box, click and drag to move it anywhere you wish. Click View Pop-Up and enter any relevant information that you want to here. Now, if for some reason you forgot to add some text in the previous steps of when you were putting together your content, you can use this text area. I would recommend that you do it prior to coming here, but in the event that you need to do it, we can always do it this way. We can click Add Text. Now, again, this option is if you did not put the text in the original doc. So it works much the same way. You can adjust the box. You can click and drag to move it around. Now, for some reason, you're like, ooh, I don't want the pop-up. I don't want this text box. All you have to do is right-click it, and you can select Delete Pop-up or Delete Text to remove it. Now, if you're all set, you're gonna go ahead and click File, select Save for Publishing. You're gonna save as a MOBI file. This is Kindle ready. So MOBI is a Kindle readable file. And the nice thing is when we upload this later on to be published, KDP doesn't have to do anything for formatting. It is already set. Now, as soon as you hit Save as a MOBI file, it's gonna take a while to process. In fact, you're gonna probably wanna go make yourself a burger and a coffee and just relax because your computer's gonna be doing all the work. Just let it do its thing. And now when it's finished, you're actually going to be instructed on how to upload over to KDP. But good news, I'm gonna actually show you in the very next video inside this four-part series how to self-publish a children's book. I'm gonna show you how to do it in roughly about 5 minutes, less than 10 minutes for both print book and ebook. I'll see you there.